just a bunch of kids.
We got off.
But man, we patriotic.
They fought in World War II, returned home to Iowa, and really rarely talked about their experiences for the next 65 years. But tonight, 350 of those veterans can't stop talking.
They just got back from a cross-country thank-you trip. And News Channel 8's Eric Hansen was on board the honor flight as Iowa's war heroes walked into the memorial for the first time.
It was a really cool experience, Stacey. Most 80 or 90-year-olds wouldn't consider taking a 22-hour road trip in one day, but 1,300 Iowans have signed up for this one. The first 350 from central Iowa went yesterday, leaving behind plenty of tears and rekindling plenty of old memories.
When you're 5 or 6, early morning bus rides are no big deal.
This isn't the morning to be late, is it?
No.
Add 80 or 90 years to the equation.
Okay, I'm on. All right. McAdoo.
Smiles start brewing long before the coffee.
We're going to help you get on the bus, okay?
But the moment this day really sank in was when thousands of strangers showed up at the bus stop underneath a chartered 747.
Have a great day, okay?
Looks like a good start.
I didn't think I'd see the day.
Watching weathered hands scale a jumbo jet staircase gives you a glimpse of their determination.
Honor to have you on board, sir.
Thank you.
But once all 351 veterans touched down in Washington, it's easy to see why hardened heroes suddenly got goosebumps.
Welcome.
Thank you for your service.
Welcome to Washington, sir. Thank you.
It's hard to express in people's language that will understand.
Look at that. Isn't that cool?
By the time all 11 chartered buses pulled up to their final destination, these grandpas were tempted to play piggyback with their sons and granddaughters who met them there.
Because they're family, Eric. And it's great.
And we're proud of them.
It doesn't get any better than this.
Jack, thank you for your service. Welcome to your memorial.
Suddenly, 351 war heroes were surrounded by a stone tribute to their sacrifice.
This is outstanding.
I'm just an old stick farmer, has been. And I just can't believe ever seeing this in the first place.
And it's just like a renewal of my spirits to see this. I mean, it's just like it's inspiring.
The memorial to battles on land and sea flowed with gold shirts and gray hair.
The European theaters over here.
Rekindling painful memories.
I just know that God spared my life. I got a snake bite and I was in a coma for 3 weeks. And when I come back to the company, I was a sergeant of the company. Half of them are gone. I could have been that half.
And remembering brothers closer than brothers.
You know, they gave their life. What else can you do?
I lost friends. I had a sister who passed away with cancer 17 years ago and a younger brother passed away about 12 years ago with cancer. But I was closer to some of my friends in the Marine Corps than to my own sister and brother.
Millions visit this place.
They don't understand. Freedom is not free. You have to sacrifice for it.
Veterans feel it.
We did it because we wanted our freedom, and I think that's really what it's all about.
But bring this mini.
100 years old right here.
And the veteran behind it will check out of the hospital and show up in person.
We've had up into 70,000 visits so far. It's the greatest program I've ever been involved in with veterans.
In one afternoon, Iowa's aging heroes posed like celebrities.
Okay, let's have a picture with her. Okay.
Watch the guards change at Arlington and trace names from Vietnam's wall. Then it would hit again.
So when you walk up and when you see this, tell me about that.
You see, Iwo Jima isn't just a statue.
I witnessed this.
It's a battle Lyle Colligan lived.
It is very special. Very special.
A fight Paul Lawrence fought.
You have no idea. You have no idea. I'm sorry if I sound sad, but it gets to me.
And an island where Les Mathry raised a small flag hours before this second one was captured on film.
We knew the job wasn't over, but the island was ours. We'll put it that way.
Not a story, not a tear, not a minute of this day would have happened if Hy-Vee didn't step forward and donate $250,000 for this exhausting, emotional experience.
That is impressive. I mean, I can't. We're going to shop at Hy-Vee forever.
But if anyone believes these veterans didn't pay for this 65 years ago, they are sorely mistaken.
We're just a bunch of kids. We got off, but man, were we patriotic.
Albert, watch your stuff right here, okay?
Just a wonderful day. I enjoyed it so immensely, I'll tell you.
And I will never forget it.
350 veterans went yesterday, but 950 more are on the waiting list. They're all over 80 years old, which is why organizers are moving so quickly. All of the information and plenty more pictures are on our website. Those senior citizens were definitely drained when we got home, as were all of us, but they went to bed as heroes.
Yeah. Thank you, Eric. Yeah.